What Megan's rings really say about her. How the art of ring palmistry can decode the stars' insecurities and desires by the beeling on their fingers. When Meghan Markle accompanied Prince Harry on their second official walkabout in Brixton earlier this week, it wasn't her engagement ring that attracted most attention but the intriguing jewelry she wore on the fingers of her right hand. What did this unusual collection of rings, on her thumb, index and four fingers, possibly signify? Quite a bit, apparently. Johnny Fincham, the Norfolk-based author of the world-known best-selling book on hand reading, Palmistry, Apprentice to Pro in 24 Hours, says people were right to wonder, and that palmistry, the ancient art of divining people's personality from their hands, gives a fascinating insight into a person's character. When we look at the human brain, we find a huge portion of it is devoted to our hands, interpreting the sensations they feel and the way they move, he says. And when the digits are embraced by a ring, research has shown that this actually affects our behavior. And Meghan's not alone in embracing multiple rings. Celebrities from Victoria Beckham to Kate Winslet and Cara Delevingne have also embraced the trend. So how does where you wear a ring affect your behavior, and what does it say about you? The thumbs are about self-control and willpower, says Johnny Fincham, who also lectures in palmistry at the London School of Astrology. The development of the oppositional thumb is the key evolutionary advance that made humans able to control their destiny. When a person wears a ring on the thumb, it represents a drive for more power. And, given the parallels frequently drawn between Harry's fiancé, ambassador for the charities UNICEF and World Vision Canada, and his late mother, Princess Diana, who championed numerous humanitarian causes, it's perhaps unsurprising that he adds, thumb rings are also worn by those who want to change the world in some way, pacifists, eco-warriors, feminists, socialists. One thing seems clear, Ms. Markle is a force to be reckoned with. Meghan also, notably, wore a matching band on the index finger of her right hand, a style which has likewise been adopted by Victoria Beckham. Palmists refer to this as the mirror finger and believe it is ruled by the planet Jupiter and plays a significant role in self-reflection and self-esteem. 80. Wearing a ring on this digit is said to show a frustrated need for power and recognition, something which may resonate with Posh, so often overshadowed by her footballing legend husband, David Beckham, but, given the public adulation, that is no longer in short supply for Meghan. Wearing a ring on the index finger can help boost your sense of self, says Johnny Fincham. It can act as a reminder to pull your finger out, as it were, helping you to grow in stature and develop in power. Referred to by palmists as the wall finger, due to its central, stable position on the hand, the middle digit is linked to your lifestyle and morals. We live in a time when traditional values are collapsing, which is perhaps why it is increasingly common to wear a ring on this digit, says Johnny. The related internal conflict is one of struggling to find a role in society and insecurity about one's place in life. Harry Potter actress Emma Watson is often seen sporting a ring on this finger and, vociferous on the subject of gender equality, has proved herself unwilling to be seen as merely another glamorous film star and, instead, keen to use her high profile to make a difference. Accompanied at last week's Golden Globe Awards ceremony by Mai Literacy, an activist and executive director of the British-based black feminist organization Icon, Emma, who rose to fame playing Harry's studious friend Hermione Granger, told the world that she had experienced the full spectrum of sexual harassment in Hollywood. This, of course, is where we usually wear a wedding ring, and for good reason. This finger has a direct meridian line connection to the heart in traditional Chinese medicine, says Johnny. Ancient Egyptians believed the vena amoris, the vein of love, made a connection between this finger and the heart. The ring places restrictions on its earnings, important once a commitment is made. Much has been written about the controlling nature of Katie Holmes's marriage to screen idol Tom Cruise. And those searching for signals as to how the whole affair has played out need look no further than the actress's ring finger. Her rock of an engagement ring from the Top Gun actor was one of the most ostentatious ever seen in Hollywood. However, their six-year marriage fell apart in 2012, amid claims that Katie objected to Cruise's commitment to Scientology. It was recently reported that, as part of their divorce settlement, Katie had agreed to keep quiet about any future relationships. And how did she eventually communicate her latest long-term love of actor Jamie Foxx to the world? with a much subtler diamond set in yellow gold on her ring finger. The little finger is known as the antenna in modern palmistry, as it's all about communication, verbal, physical and sexual. Johnny Fincham says in many cultures, a ring on this finger denotes sexual openness. That's something actress Kate Winslet, who has 3 children by 3 men and is a fan of wearing a ring on her pinky, may want to bear in mind, assuming she has no intention of moving on from husband No. 3, Matt Mockbrill. It's enormously common for sexually curious people to wear a large ring on their little finger, adds Johnny. The same is true for those who are concerned with communication, for instance writers and public speakers. Those who feel the need to wear rings on every finger tend to have insecure and troubled personalities, according to Johnny. This is very common among adolescents when they're establishing themselves in the adult world, and on people who feel alienated in some way, he adds. It's also often seen on the hands of showbiz personalities. Singer Alright Hannah, who has had her share of troubles, including being the victim of domestic violence at the hands of ex-boyfriend Chris Brown, and who recently buried her beloved cousin, murdered on Boxing Day, is among those who have adopted this style. Johnny would advise anyone struggling to break the habit to wean themselves off, one ring at a time. You'll find yourself feeling psychologically naked at first, he warns. But you will soon develop a compensatory inner strength. When it comes to longevity and commitment, the best wedding bands are, according to Johnny, slim and gold with a single small sapphire, traditionally associated with honesty. Thicker rings are, perhaps unsurprisingly, more commonly associated with the kind of costume jewelry favored by the young and traditionally free and single. A ring which doesn't form a full circle on the ring finger, but instead spirals up a digit, suggests an open approach to partnerships and may, therefore, inadvertently send out the wrong signals. As well as the positioning of a ring, the material it is made from also influences its power, says Johnny. Gold is traditionally associated with Apollo, the sun god, who was both loyal and protective, ideal qualities in a spouse, which is perhaps what makes it the perfect metal for a wedding band. A silver ring, especially worn on the thumb of the dominant hand, is perfect for those who have set themselves targets, such as getting up to do early morning yoga or sticking to a diet. This is because silver is said to have special links to guidance from a higher power. Tin, meanwhile, is a metal associated with Jupiter, king of the gods, so anyone feeling vulnerable or neglected should opt for pewter or base metal bands, both of which contain tin, to give themselves a confidence boost. Many cultures throughout the ages have attached special significance to the various jewels with which we adorned ourselves. Diamonds are believed to absorb and amplify the thoughts of those wearing them and were once used for detoxification as they were said to protect people from poisons. Emeralds are said to aid fertility, as well as improve eyesight, lift depression and relieve insomnia. Opals are strongly associated with emotions, including love and passion, while rubies are believed to protect from misfortune and bad health, as well as being a symbol of friendship and love. Sapphires, the queen's favorite jewel, have long been associated with peace and happiness and are said to help with communication, as well as inspiration.